It's a new life for one very old tree. Back in January, when crews in Yarmouth cut down a 217-year-old American elm, affectionately known as Herbie, much of the wood was sold to artists and craftsmen. This weekend, many of their finished pieces will be up for auction, and the proceeds will benefit the town of Yarmouth. News 8's Steve Minich joins us from the newsroom with an update. Steve?
Well, Tracy, at 110 feet tall, Herbie was well documented as New England's largest American elm, an iconic piece of the town's history. It survives today in many forms of art and furniture.
Cut from a single tree, dozens of different pieces.
Quite amazing.
From the smallest of artifacts to fine hand-carved furniture. Even a one-of-its-kind electric guitar. Each of these craftsmen drawn to this project, they say, for one simple reason.
Because it's Herbie. I mean, this is a major historic tree.
That historic tree today survives in the form of the Herbie Project, which through this weekend's auction will raise hopefully thousands of dollars, allowing Yarmouth to plant up to 25 new trees a year.
I think people don't realize how expensive a tree is. A mere 2.5-inch caliper tree is about $250.
You're looking exactly at a growth rate right here.
Furniture maker Bob Newton was there the day Herbie fell. He says immediately he realized he was looking at a special piece of wood.
When I saw the tree come down and I saw the color of the wood, I thought, oh, this is going to be maybe something to try to do.
The result is really stunning. It's a very beautiful, very attractive wood.
For generations, Herbie towered over the town of Yarmouth, but today, it's the seed. By auctioning off the remnants carved from that single tree, dozens more will grow.
It's a totally sustainable project. It's gone from a tree that was standing into final keepsake heirlooms of wood art here in the state of Maine.
And if you would like to own a piece of Herbie, the auction starts tomorrow evening at 5 at the Delora Map Company in Yarmouth. There will be both a silent and a live auction. In the newsroom, Steve Minich, News 8.